How are you?
Today we're in Māngere with its local Member of Parliament.
I didn't plant these guys.
It's well rehearsed.
Okay, it wasn't a setup, but Aupito William Sio has been set in this electorate for almost 15 years as the Labour Party MP.
All politics is local. Doesn't matter whether you're a minister or the Prime Minister. Really important to touch base on the ground.
And he certainly has done the groundwork.
I was always aware that a voice for the Pacific was important. You could not necessarily speak confidently unless you were engaging and you were talking to people and that you were reaching in to the various sectors of our community, a sector often not recognised by decision makers. 1989, the elders said, well, we want our own voice in Parliament. And so we set out on a campaign to get the Labour Party to select a Pacific person. And so, you know, one thing led to another, but I was constantly pushed by the elders to be a voice.
But before the Beehive, he used his voice in local government as councillor for the Ōtara ward. Then in 2007 came the role no other Pasifika person has held, deputy mayor of Monaco City, a job that would set him up well for what was to come.
You can't take full credit for it all, but obviously somebody has to try and lead that, push things through, open the doors, and I think that's been my role.
Born in Samoa, his family migrated to New Zealand when he was 8 years old. He grew up and has lived in South Auckland ever since.
I coined the phrase Generation 6B to try and describe this wonderful generation that's coming through of young people who are proudly brown, beautiful, brainy, bilingual, bicultural, bold. I tease people by saying, well, only among it is Generation 8Bs, because we're just brilliantly blessed. But I was trying to lift their aspirations, to lift their confidence.
He entered Parliament in 2008, and after years of advocating in the opposition, the Labour Party took power in 2017, and Aupito became Minister for Pacific Peoples. He also became an Associate Minister of Justice, Foreign Affairs, Education and Pacific Health.
The feedback that I'm constantly getting from young people and elders is that when I was a minister, I was able to reflect back to them that it was okay to be different, that it was okay to speak your own language, that it was okay to be Pacific peoples of Aotearoa.
And Aupito's work in the community paid dividends as a voice of calm and assurance for the Pacific community during the COVID lockdown, helping to develop the unique messaging targeted at Pacific people to keep them safe during this period.
COVID-19 is still present in Aotearoa New Zealand and around the world. And while that remains the case, we must remain alert, work to manage the risks and keep everyone safe.
Then in 2021, Aupito realised a personal milestone when the government apologised for its role in the Dawn Raids immigration crackdown of the early 1970s. Alleged overstayers, mostly Pacific Islanders, were targeted, including Aupito's own family.
It was quite a painful and emotional moment because I and my family experienced Dawn Raid, and here I am trying to put everything together. Really will be eternally grateful to Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern for trusting in what I had recommended and for trusting to put herself under the mat in terms of the ifonga. And I'll never forget that.
But the life of a politician is scattered with momentous occasions like this and the day-to-day challenges and sacrifices. Behind this very public figure is his very private life that he tries to protect.
My daughters and my older kids have always kept me grounded, and my wife. I would not be able to do this job or not have been able to dedicate myself to this role if they did not give me the support. The sacrifice has been theirs.
Come October, Aupito is closing that door on politics, but he says he'll be around.
Will you miss it?
I think there'll be some elements you miss. You build a family of people that are committed to the same values and wanting to build a better nation for the next generation. And you miss those debates, you miss the singing, miss the dancing, but not really. I think, you have the opportunities I have, you've got to make the most of it. We've got to work fast while the sun is shining, and then you've got to move on.